everybody. I'm Sarah here at the EarlyON. Today I'm going to challenge you to do some painting at home using things around your house that you might not have thought of using before. The first thing I'm going to show you is painting with yarn. So any yarn or string you have at home will work. Just cut your yarn into short lengths and have your child dip it into the paint. This one has a super fuzzy texture. And then you're just gonna dip and dab it on your paper and try to make trails and lines. Okay, just a little more paint. And you can even spread it and just have them drag it along the paper and see what kind of pattern you get. Another easy thing you can make at home is a sponge painter. If you have some sponge or scrubby pad, cut them up into small pieces and a simple wooden clothespin. We're gonna stick this together like that, and you're gonna dip it in your paint and sponge paint. Make different prints. You can even try cutting your sponge into different shapes if you like. Another simple idea to do at home is if you don't have paintbrushes handy, try something else like Q-tips. Dip those in your paint, and you're gonna make polka dots. See if your child can make patterns or little prints, little flowers. This is actually an art technique called pointillism. So give that a try. An inexpensive item you can buy at the dollar store is these hard canvas. It's something different than using basic paper at home. What I want to challenge you to do today is look around your home and think outside of the box for things you can use at home for your child to paint with. So one thing you might have is cookie cutters in your kitchen. So with these, you're going to dab them in the paint and press them down to make prints. Let's try this teddy bear too. So get it all along the edges and make some prints with those. Another toy your child might have at home is Lego. These are really great and simple for making prints. You can dip those in, make some nice squares. You can even flip them around and use the bumpy side. So as you can see, it makes really neat prints on there. Raid the toy box again. Check out for little cars. Drive those through the paint and drive them on your canvas. Your child might have fun looking at the different tire tracks their vehicles make, or maybe you might want to make a whole roadway at home. How about toy animals or dinosaurs? Dip their little feet in the paint and track them across your canvas, like so. Another thing you might want to think about is raiding your utensil drawer. So here I have a potato masher, a fork. I've had the kids here at playgroup paint with baster brushes as well. So same idea, you're gonna dip your utensils in the paint and have your child stamp them on the paper to make prints. And even the basic fork can make neat prints as well. So you can see both of those made lines on my paper. So just experiment, be brave, don't be afraid of a little mess. If you want to do something different than canvas and paper, try giving your child a piece of tin foil to paint with. And same thing, just have them use their brushes or the toys you're using that day to paint on the tin foil, and it does give a different kind of effect. So remember to be creative when you're at home painting with your child. Be creative, think outside of the box, look around your house, see what you could use instead of a basic paintbrush. And remember, it's about the process, not the finished product. Let them have fun experimenting with paint, mixing the colors and that kind of thing. I hope you guys have fun with this at home. Bye.